This program is sponsored by NEPC.
एक तुम ही थे उनका सपना, अब बन गए वो ख्वाब अपना। घर की याद सताए, समय क्यों ना पंख फैलाए।
Airlines.
Good morning and welcome to the NEPC Business Breakfast. Today's bulletin is on how consumer electronics companies are whetting our appetites. And our guest is Pradeep Kar, the CMD of Microland. But first, the morning's headlines. Sensex drops below 3,000, Reliance, ACC, ITC and other scripts touch new 52-week lows. Tisco records best ever first half performance and 132% spurt in net profits. And the Foreign Investment Promotion Board approves a 300 crore rupee fresh investment by Pepsi in beverages and foods. Morning, Pradeep.
Morning.
The stock market's taking another tumble, all scripts touching new all-time lows. How is this affecting small and medium entrepreneurs like you?
I guess the impact is on two folds. The cost of raising money is expensive, and therefore the average cost in the last few months has increased by a couple of points. On the second aspect is companies who have decided to raise equity capital or enhance the equity capital will find it more difficult currently and will have to defer and postpone their plans.
Now, what options are available for people like you? Big companies can always raise money abroad, but for medium companies like you?
I guess companies who have a track record, they can raise the money, they can find the money. The cost becomes a marginal issue. But we have not, as a business, found it difficult to raise money. It's more expensive.
Mm-hmm. Pradeep, the Foreign Investment Promotion Board approving Pepsi's 300 crore rupee proposal, potato chips, more potato chips. You're in the computer chip business. What's your position on this computer chip versus potato chip controversy?
I guess that it makes sense for international companies to invest in areas where India has strong raw material strengths, like food, like agriculture. Mm-hmm. It does not make sense for companies to invest in semiconductor facilities or fabrication units. Mm-hmm. Therefore, from that perspective, I would assume that businesses must invest in India, where India has raw materials, manpower, design facilities, cotton, pulses, etc.
But tell me, can we ever be a major industrial power without investments in semiconductor manufacturing and fabrication?
Certainly, because the key element here is knowledge. Key element is software. Mm. We can design the chips and we can get them fabricated overseas. Mm.
We had a facility in Chandigarh, but that burned down, isn't it? And then subsequently nothing really has come up.
That was the only facility that came up in the late 80s.
But would major companies like Intel, Motorola and so on would be interested in coming to India for fabrication and design?
Over a period of time, yes, because as the computer industry and the entertainment industry come closer, the number of chips required to run appliances increased dramatically. Mm-hmm. And therefore the key processes would be based in the US, and secondary and processes and supporting chips will have to be designed overseas.
Is there a role for government here, or is this entirely to be driven by private industry?
No, the government has to play a hand with the industry, supporting the industry in creating the centers, working with key leaders in this industry to ask them to come and set up these facilities here.
Pradeep, you mentioned the fact that our comparative advantage is knowledge. It's really people.
Yes.
Are you facing a crunch in terms of getting people, designers, application-specific designers?
Absolutely.
It's a paradox, no? We have so many people, and yet you are saying that people are the biggest problem.
Yeah, but India has few advantages. For example, availability is there are people available. They're English speaking. Mm-hmm. They are basically engineering and science graduates. Mm-hmm. From that perspective, from this quantum, India certainly has a distinct advantage. Mm-hmm. But from the second perspective, the average person or the engineer in the Indian environment is not exposed to the technologies and the processes and the, I would say, support tools that are available for the engineer overseas.
So really training is essential.
Yeah.
Finally, Pradeep, 5 years ago you were nowhere, you're an 80 crore company now. What lessons from your own experience for small and medium entrepreneurs?
Basically two or three lessons. One is the business has to be capitalized early in the game, early in the years, and it's necessary for the company to have adequate money to fund its growth. We were fortunate that in the initial years we had venture capital funding available from SBI Capital Markets earlier to now TDICI, and that has made a significant difference. The second element is that you need to be able to share your perspective of business, share your future dreams with potential people that you want them to, who you want to join the business. And the paradox here is that the larger companies can do with mediocre people, whereas smaller companies must have brighter people. And these are two elements.
In other words, no fiscal incentives, but venture capital was the key.
Absolutely.
Thank you, Pradeep, and good luck.
Thank you.
That was Pradeep Kar, the CMD of Microland, discussing the day's headlines. We'll return after the break with more electronics gizmos on display at the India International Trade Fair. Do stay with us.
Oh, Mrs. Poovala, kitty party ko hai jana, dadi ma gaya chela nabla.
Bombay, Calcutta, Bombay. Damania Airways, expect the world of us.
Welcome back. Move over, Uncle Sam. Brother Samsung is here. Konkana Das reports.
Consumer electronics companies are attempting to break into people's homes. They're wooing the Indian customer with their very best televisions and music systems at the ongoing trade fair in New Delhi. And Delhiites are descending on the Pragati Maidan for a closer look at what's on offer. Among the companies here is the Korean giant Samsung, the latest entrant to the 4,000 crore rupee Indian consumer electronics market. And it's certainly making its presence known.
Our best model, what we are going to introduce coming December, is a 29-inch world best model. And that has a very extra feature which has not been introduced all over the world.
Samsung claims that the world best TV has the flattest screen, which minimizes distortion. It's also launching here a 21-inch television with a built-in 4-head VCR. But there's a lot else that is high-tech and vying for attention, like the 1200-watt latest audio system from Sansui and Videocon's double-window television.
It has double window. You can watch two programs simultaneously with two audio output also. It has 100 channels.
It's the range of televisions that is drawing the crowds. And naturally, most attractive among them are the widescreen TVs, full, flat, totally remote controlled, with VCR, without VCR, with surround sound, and even 3D picture. And these companies are showing their best colors to capture the expanding market.
We also feel that with new products and new companies coming in, we have geared up our product lineups. For example, we have now 15 color televisions in the range, starting from a figure of 12,000 till 1,75,000.
Another major draw here are these laser disc home theater sets with price tags of 1.5 lakh rupees and more. But money doesn't seem to be a concern for some customers or even the new companies.
We think the first initial couple of years loss might be significant, but we might think there is a price we have to pay for establishment of our market investment.
While TVs drew the most crowds, hi-fi sound systems split quite a few eardrums. And if that's not enough, there was plenty of hard sell too.
And another than that, it has a jog dial where you can just by rotating it, you can get a song whichever you like, instead of going on keeping pressing the system. And it has a 5-button display is there. And other than that, you can have 5 modes of sound with a bus expander.
That's all for today. This is Jairam Ramesh signing off for the NEPC Business Breakfast. Keep writing to us at Box 524, New Delhi 11001 or fax us at 011-3355-802. We look forward to hearing from you and have a nice day.
This program was sponsored by NEPC.